pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mr. Steppen, will you take attendance, please?
Certainly. President Alessandro.
Here.
Vice President Brazington.
Here.
Secretary Steppen's here. Treasurer Guthrie.
Here.
Trustee Donnelly.
Here.
Trustee Schaefer.
Here.
Trustee Bailey.
Here.
Okay, thank you. Any changes to the agenda?
None.
Item 3, consent agenda, which is the minutes of September 26th, and personal recommendations. Have a motion, please. Mrs. Schaefer.
Move to approve the consent agenda as presented.
Support. Support, Mr. Donnelly. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Item 4, prearranged request to address the board. Board of Education matters? Item 6, curriculum and instruction, Mr. Weaver.
Nothing.
Take a deep breath and say that.
The record state, that might be a first. Item 7, finance and operation, Mr. Barnard.
Nothing on the agenda, however, I just simply wanted to mention that coming at the next board meeting on the 24th, we will have our auditors present the 2016-17 audited financial information. That's when they are scheduled.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Item 8, human resources, Nancy is...
Nancy's not here, but Denise is gonna just speak to a couple of...
Okay.
On the consent agenda, there were some teacher recommendations. Not in that group was Devin Banks. He is going to be the dean of students. He was not in that because he's an at-will employee. So he comes from Chandler Park Academy. He has a master's in educational leadership from U of M, and he also holds an administrative certificate. So.
And that is out at the middle school.
At the middle school, dean at the middle school. Christine, I'm not even going to try the last name.
It's Christina Fanzopoulos.
There you go. She is going to be a special education teacher at Lakeville in the resource room. She comes from Lapeer ISD, and she holds a master's in learning disabilities from Wayne State. And then we have Sarah, a special education teacher at the middle school. And she comes from Detroit Service Learning Academy and also holds a master's in special education from Oakland University.
Very good.
Excited with those hires.
Okay. Moving on, item 9, Denise.
That's me.
Student services.
I'm taking over for Ken tonight.
Oh, boy.
I've got a whole lot of PowerPoint for you. Schools of Choice recommendation you will see in the next board meeting, but just to let you know, the recommendation we're looking at is kindergarten through 9th unlimited and 6th through 11th unlimited at the virtual academy. That will be our recommendation.
Okay, we look forward to that.
And just for the record, just for the record, that is the same verbiage that we used a year ago for the spring as well. So no changes in that regard.
Question.
Yes.
Just a quick question, sir.
Yes.
Not no 9 through 12 school of choice?
Kindergarten through 9.
Right. Okay, 10.
Through 9. 10th, 11th, and 12th, we are never open for a second semester.
Oh, okay.
This
first,
is just first semester. We are second semester. We are not.
Thank you. Okay.
And then also just to let you know that Last Wednesday was count day, so we are in the middle of counting all of our students. We have a 10-day attendance window and a 30-school-day attendance window that we have to count students who are absent on that day. There's also some requirements for online learners and mentor contacts. So we have a 30-school-day window for that as well. So I will be ready to present some preliminary numbers by that first board meeting in November.
Like our FTE numbers?
Yes, yes. I'm confident that those numbers are going to be an increase from last year, but there's lots of factors that play into the next 30 days, so.
What did we unveil last year? I know I have it written down.
I don't have that with me. Last year in the fall was, I think, like $5,900, something.
That was the fall,
maybe.
Okay.
That could have been a preliminary.
Okay.
Mr. Crowe?
I think the fall was like 5904, and for the first time in a long time, our spring count was higher than the fall, and I think that was the 5930-something number.
I can get that for you.
Okay.
So I'm curious. I'll be back on November 8th with the preliminary number.
Very good.
And that's it?
All right. Wow.
I tried to be quick.
Long way to go to catch up with Ken Weaver. All right. Item 10, board policy. We don't have any on the docket. Item 11, unscheduled audience participation.
Come on, whoop it up, somebody. Let's go.
Elise, good. All right. Moving on. Item 12, clarification.
No.
Scheduled activities. We have October 14th, the homecoming dance.
So what exactly is the homecoming dance?
Could have a presentation on each of these items. Okay.
October 17th, there are teacher conferences here at the high school. October 16th and 17th is the Lake Clear Lake Elementary IB visits. October 18th, the fall choir event at the high school. October 19th, parent-teacher conferences again here at the high school. October 24th is our next board meeting. October 26th is the band concert for 7th and 8th graders. And the 27th of October is our first quarter ends at the middle school. And these will all be posted on the website. So if there's any questions, you can find them there. Item 14, final board comments, Mr. Donnelly.
Mr. Stevick, should we?
No. Mr. Chairman, I just want to thank Mr. Throne. This last week or 10 days has been kind of weird. Your level of communication with us, letting us know what's going on, second to none. So I just appreciate your communication, appreciate how the staff dealt with some of the weird stuff, all the way to flooding basements and all sorts of stuff. So thank you.
Dr. Brazington.
I echo Mr. Donnelly's comments. Thank you.
Mr. Maven, or I'm sorry, Mrs. Schaefer.
Same. I mean, you guys all got my texts this week. We had a lot going on as a district, and Tim really handled it extremely well. And his professionalism was with anything from the media to parents to the staff, I thought was exceptional. So hats off to that. And I'm sure you had a team of minions helping you out. I know Tony took a lot of heat this week too and had a lot of jobs on his plate, so thank you for that.
Mr. Bailey?
I would agree with that completely.
Echo.
Hail to the chief.
That's all I got. Well, I am going to add just a little bit. Echo what you've all said. Tim did a great job. But I also want the board to know that you played a very, very big role in letting the staff handle it. Our job is not to get involved in the day-to-day, and that truly was day-to-day things. And I'm very, very proud of the way that we let our folks handle the situations that they are hired to do. So I wanted to also tip my hat to you all, tip my hat to the staff that handled them. It was a trying week. working through it, and the goal is to do things right every time, and we did that. So thank you again, Tim. Thank everybody involved for us. Appreciate it. Mr. Throne.
So thank you very much for the kind words. I definitely will share that with our team, and many of them are obviously here tonight. You know, whether it was the high school or, you know, just cabinet members or really just a number of administrative staff people really stepped up. And I told them today at our ad team meeting that, you know, while we can't always pick and choose when and how we want to learn, I really felt like over the last week and a half, we've really continued to build that internal capacity and growth amongst ourselves, and not only communication and how we handle different things, but also capacity as a team together and anticipating and being able to rely upon one another. And so they all just did a tremendous job. Just a couple of things that I want to let the board know of, just other things that's on the docket. This month we're having a lot of IV reauthorizations, so there's just a lot of activity in the schools with that. For the first time, we're identifying all of our students K through third grade in their reading and reporting back to those parents, students that may have any type of delay and that kind of thing. Ken and Janet will also be attending a national INACL conference. I've attended this conference a few times in the past, and it's probably the premier conference when it comes to speaking to personalization and I don't want to say just online learning, because it's not just all online learning, but it's really about personalized learning. And so they will be attending that conference later this month, and obviously Dan already read, we will have parent-teacher conferences coming up as well. So a lot of activities, a lot of things going on in the district, but a lot of good things. So.
Okay. All right. Item 15, other. I am going to just add one thing, and it's important that November 7th, we have the bond and sinking fund vote. Now, while I'm very well aware of what we can and can't say, we can inform you that there is a vote on November 7th, and it's revolving around the school bond and sinking fund. So what I will say is that please educate yourselves as much as you can about both topics. There are two separate topics on there. So if you have any questions, you can find information on the district page, or you can stop in the superintendent's office, ask him any questions you may have. So with that.
And Wednesdays.
And Wednesdays. Wednesdays we have our meeting, but they kind of moved. This Wednesday, the informational meeting is going to be
in my office.
At Firmly Rooted office, which is a couple doors down from the district office.
Okay.
And then anybody that's there will get the information on where the next one will be. Okay? Anything other? All right. Meeting adjourned.